thinking, well, we're going to go ahead and expand a little bit about our accounting equation. Now, the last video that you watched, it just kind of introduced you to the accounting equation, and that was that assets will always equal liabilities plus owner's equity. And that's what we use to record business transactions in a business. And we always want to make sure that the total of our assets always equal the liabilities plus the owner's equity. Assets are things of value like cash, or supplies. These are things owned by the business. They use these things to help them generate money. Liabilities are debts. And debts, a great example of the one that we're going to use in this chapter is accounts payable. This is like a credit card. When a business decides that it's going to charge something, it uses accounts payable. It's waiting to pay this money. And then owner's equity, and that's what we used in the last video, but we're going to go ahead and expand our owner's equity. And owner's equity is affected by four things. And those four things include, an easy way to remember it is WIRE, or wire. So it's affected, of course, by investments that the owner makes. This is a personal investment in the business to help generate or give money to the business when it's starting out. It's also affected by withdrawals. So if the owner decided, hey, I want to go to Vegas this weekend, they might decide to pull out a little bit of money, and then it's a personal withdrawal, and that's considered a reduction in our owner's equity. It's also affected, owner's equity, by revenues. If the business generates revenues via selling a product or providing a service, then that would cause owner equity to go up. And then expenses are the costs of doing business. So E stands for expenses. So WIRE, those are the four things that affect owner's equity. Withdrawals cause owner's equity to go down. Investments cause our owner's equity to go up. Revenues cause owner's equity to go up. Because really, who is benefiting when money is made by the business? The owner, right? And then, of course, expenses cause that owner's equity to go down. So these are the four things that affect our owner's equity. Let's go ahead and see what would happen when we record transactions using our accounting equation. Let's just try a couple. Let's say that the business needs money. It's just starting out and it needs some money. And so the owner decides, hey, I'm gonna go ahead and put some money in so I can start making some money. It's gonna make an investment, or the owner is gonna make an investment. And we're gonna call our investment account, we're gonna call it a capital. So this is going to be the owner's capital account. And this is where we're going to record any type of investments that the business receives via the owner. The owner decides to put in $1,000 to start out. Well, that means that our cash is going up $1,000. It also means that our owner's capital went up $1,000. The left side of our accounting equation went up 1,000. The right side of our accounting equation went up 1,000. So our equation is in balance. Remember, that's very important. It always has to remain in balance. Let's try another transaction. Let's say that the business decides to purchase supplies on account. And that means that it charged it. It doesn't want to pay for the supplies right now. It doesn't want to use any of its money. So they're going to charge it. Well, we know that supplies is going to go up. Let's say they bought $300 of supplies. So supplies went up by $300. Since they charged it, that means that they owe $300. So assets went up $300, liabilities went up $300, so our equation should remain in balance because the total of these two is $1,300. The total of this plus our owner equity is $1,300, and we still are in balance. Let's try one more. Let's say that the business has to pay rent. Well, rent is a cost of doing business, and that would be considered an expense. Well, let's say that the rent was $200. That means that our expenses went up $200, and that caused our owner equity to go down. And, of course, if we paid it, then that means that our cash went down by $200. So cash went down by $200. Our owner equity went down by $200. The the total of the left side of our accounting equation has to equal the total of our right. So let's see if it does. Well, we have a total of cash of $800, plus we have $300 of supplies, so the total of our left side is $1,100. Let's take a look at our right side. Our liabilities total is $300. Our owner's capital account was $1,000, but our expenses caused it to go down by $200. So the total of our owner equity is $800. If we add these two together, $300 plus $800 is $1,100, and our accounting equation is in balance. Good job!